minutes ago.
Oh, hello. My name is Derek Lee Huffman. I'm a sophomore management major, and I'm doing my report on how can students and other citizens contribute to conserving gasoline and other fossil fuels. The first step I've said in order to help conserve fuel is to drive a hybrid. A hybrid car is good for the environment, and also there are fewer emissions when the gasoline is burned to produce energy. For vehicles, carbon monoxide is created and released into the environment. Another way that you can conserve gas and other fossil fuels is to carpool. Carpooling is when, like, you or a workmate, one of your employees or employers or classmate stay in the same, within the same area, and they're going to the same place. You pick them up and a couple other friends, and that kind of helps to stop everybody from driving their car to the same place, and it really conserves gas. If you have a friend at work or school, carpooling would save a lot of gas. I say this because if your friend and coworkers all ride together in one car, it helps save gas better than all of you going to the same place. Also, avoid long idling. The worst mileage a vehicle can get is 0 miles per hour, which can happen when it's just parked, staying still while it's still on. Idling for a long period of time, whether at a railroad crossing or pulling off the road to make a cell phone call, consumes gas. That could be saved by simply just turning your car off. Restarting the engine uses about the same amount of gas as just sitting there with your car running for 30 seconds would. When idling for a long period of time, shut off your engine. However, turning off the engine may disable vehicle functions, including safety features such as the airbag. Drivers should be certain to utilize the strategy in situations where there is no possible collision. Another good way is to clean out the trunk and eliminate all unnecessary weight in your vehicle. Vehicles get better mileage when they are not loaded with unnecessary weight. Even 200 blemish of additional weight trims 1 mile off fuel efficiency. Most drivers accumulate material in their vehicle trunks, and some is unnecessary. Instruct drivers to remove all non-required items from the vehicle, such as unneeded tools and materials, such as clothes and other stuff. Just keep things like jumper cables and a spare tire, stuff you will need in the long run of your car. Also, don't buy premium gas. Resist the urge to buy higher octane gas for premium performance unless the vehicle requires it. Octane has nothing to do with gasoline performance. It merely indicates the velocity factor of the combustion chamber. Unless your vehicle owner manual specifically requires you to do it, do not use premium fuel. Fuel costs could be cut as much as 10% per gallon by using regular fuel over premium. Encourage drivers to observe posted speed limits. This tip may save lives as well as fuel. The Environmental Protection Agency, also known as the EPA, eliminates a 10 to 15% improvement in fuel economy by driving 55 to 65 miles an hour. Shop around for the best fuel prices. Use a wholesale club, or grocery store. Does your company have a business membership to a warehouse chain, such as Costco, Sam's Clubs, or BJ's Whole Food Clubs? The wholesale clubs typically offer some of the lowest gas prices in town. Memberships typically $40 to $45 will offset some of the savings. If all you do is buy gas, if you stop at one of these anyway, or you're a heavy gas user, you may still find the savings worthwhile. Discount retailers, for example, Walmart and Kmart and grocery stores that have pumps also charge less than competition to get people on their lots. In addition, there's no membership fee required at the discount registers. Avoid aggressive driving. Times students show that fast starts weaving in and out of traffic and accelerating to and from a stoplight don't save much time. and wear out components such as brakes and tire faster. Simply limit quick acceleration and fast braking because increasing fuel economy when accelerating pretends you have a fresh egg underneath your right foot. A light, steady pressure helps to minimize the amount of fuel consumed and maintain a more moderate, steady speed by not driving aggressively. Drivers can save up to 20% of in fuel economy, advised by the EPA. Use cruise control during highway driving. Unnecessary changes in speed is wasteful. The use of cruise control helps improve fuel economy. Use AC, don't use your AC a lot. Use the air conditioning only when needed. The air conditioning puts extra loads on engine, forcing more fuel to be used. An air conditioner is one of the biggest drains on energy, on engine power and fuel economy. It can reduce gas consumption 5 to 10%, depending on that type of vehicle and the way it is driven. Don't use it as a fan to simply circulate air. If it's too hot to bear without AC, set it around 72 degrees. Use the vent settings as much as possible. In addition, parking in the shade increases fuel economy since not as much gas will evaporate when the car is out of the sun. Air conditioning won't need to work as hard, cool down the interior. So pretty much, don't use your air conditioner unless you need to. Unless it's like really hot and you just can't go without it. But if it's already cool and stuff, you don't need it.